The simplest and best performing autogyro I've seen is my asymmetric autogyro. I got the idea watching dust specks float down in a sunlit room. An angled shape can stay level and focus its rotation with a tail. The trick is to get the proportions and angles right. To make it, download and print the pattern from my website at realpaperflight.com or print this screen. It's made from a strip of 20-pound or 75 grams per square meter bond paper, 6 inches long by a half inch wide, but anything close to that size and paperweight will work. Cut out and flatten the rectangle. Make the first bend at these three lines. Be careful to get the fold angle just right. You can fold at the middle line, but it flies better if you roll the paper between these two dashed lines to leave some space between the blades. Make the second fold exactly along this line, bent down 90 degrees. If you don't get all the angles right, it may not fly well. Set the short wing at a slight angle to the long wing with a tail on it, about like this. Now test it. Hold it by the edges of the tail like this. Raise it up and release it with a quick but gentle spin like this. It should have a good even spin and come down slowly. If it wanders, fix the tail or bend angle. If it spins too fast or slow, adjust the angle between the blade surfaces. A flatter angle should come down slower. Once it's properly adjusted, sometimes it can start rotating without a starting spin, but it works better with one. It can come down a little slower than the Whirlybird, and it is simpler, but you have to get the proportions and angles just right. I'm James Onker, a non-traditional designer and Guinness record setter in paper aviation. To see more, see the comments and links below this video.